guys, Max here. Welcome to the fifth night of Five Nights at Freddy's 2. On the last episode, let's see. I know, Chica kept killing me even though she wasn't supposed to. That was mainly it. It was kind of like, what the crap, Chica? And I took a break and came back a different day. As you can see, it's different clothes. And yeah. Oh, and since I'm recording on Halloween, which is not going to be published by,
there's a jack-o'-lantern on the desk. Look at it.
Wait for it. Now look at it. It's cute. Oh crap, one's already gone. Wait, oh, because it's fifth night, everyone's going to be on the move.
Hello. Hey, good job, night five. Keep a close eye on things tonight, okay? From what I understand, the building is on lockdown. No one is allowed in or out, you know, especially concerning any previous employees. When we get it all sorted out, we may move into the day shift. This one just became available. We don't have a replacement for your shift yet, but we're working on it. We're gonna try to contact the original restaurant owner. I think the name of the place was Red Bear's Family Diner or something like that. It's closed for years though. I doubt we'll be able to track anybody down. So just get through one more night. Hang in there. Good night.
Wow, really? It was like the place is on complete lockdown. No one is allowed in or out. Why the crap am I still here then? Alright, now last time I had like a really big problem with that. Screw you, boy. I had a really big problem with. I lost my words. Where is Boomboy? With running out of flashlight really fast. I'll admit it. It's been my problem. You know, like when I first started, I was like, man, they gave me a flashlight. I'm going to use this thing. Like, no, tomorrow. Wait, it can run out. And then it ran out. I was like, oh, crap. Now what? And even at the end of the last episode, I can. Come on. Oh, Mangle gets me. Every time I see Mangle, part of me is just like. Screw you. Right, something's going to come. I gotta get ready for Balloon Boy. Oh. I don't know if I was quick enough. I was not on my A game. I went. Now remember, even in the sixth night of Five Nights at Freddy's 1, they were really forgiving. Like really forgiving. Like, you could sit there and go, whoo, and then do it, and you'd be fine. This game, not so much. Now, I'll speed up a little bit now that I've died. I don't want to keep episodes long. Huh? Hee. Excuse me, I bump. Okay, things are bad. Alright, go. Oh, good. The reason I said things are bad is because, both the classics last I saw were in the vents. Both of them. So, 1, 2, 3, go! Alright, we're good. Oh. Freddy. And I'm already at half power. I like how direct he is. He's just like, no nonsense. Everyone move! I'm coming for him! Alright, hopefully. Alright, so you gotta say, I'm pretty sure. But I'm already at half power. Already. That's what scares me. Huh? Pretty sure I was fast enough there. Pretty sure. Alright, we're good. Because, like, if you cheat me out of this. Alright, go. Flip. Come on, pretty sure I'm fast enough. Give me the money. That's three. Like, give me some love. That's so weird. I'm asking animatronics to give me some love. I'm like, come on. Give me some love. Tell me I'm right. Tell me I'm handsome. I remember my dad. I remember the first time my dad said that. There was like some car problem. No, it was a tractor problem. I forget what it was. It was like the engine was down, the lights was down, everything was just blown to crap on this thing. And he fixed it all in one day. Oh. I think I'm dead. Pretty sure I'm dead. Yep. Yeah, he like literally covered in grease and everything, walks in the house, tell me I'm handsome. And we're all just like, you're handsome, what'd you do? I fixed a tractor.
Really?
This is like in the middle of winter, too. So it was like snow was really... I'm from South Dakota, if you guys didn't know. I'm sure a lot of you did, because I say it a lot. But, snow was like 3 feet high. We couldn't get out, because we're out in the country. And he just walks in. Tell me I'm handsome. You're handsome, what'd you do? I fixed the tractor, which had the snowblower on it. We were like, wait. You fix it? Yeah, watch. And he goes through, and it was beautiful. Sorry, I'll speed up. Enough story time with Max. Now I'm hiccuping and burping at the same time. Yo, the height of unprofessionalism. I love the pumpkin, though. The pumpkin is my new favorite. I know I say a lot of things are my favorite. Like, I recently, actually yesterday for me, I was playing Bioshock Infinite. I was just gushing over how much I loved Elizabeth, because she's my favorite. And I do say a lot of things to my favorite. I can't cook it. But that pumpkin is like my favorite. Come on, no. I had to do it. I was like trying to look down the hallway, but it just was not letting me. Alright. That scared me. Like honestly, I don't know how long you actually have until the puppet kills you. But oh crap, there's Mangle. Alright. Never mind. Thought I'd do a quick flip. I don't know how long the puppet actually gives you until it kills you, but I hear its noise. I'm just like, oh! Alright, save a second. Wait a second. I didn't wait. Oh, did I jump the gun? Am I dead? I don't know if I'm dead. I'm about to be dead in a second. Freddy's gonna kill me. Doo-da. I think I'm dead. I don't know. He forced it down. Does that mean I'm dead? Do I win? Oh crap. Go. Once again, he's gonna force it down. I'm gonna put it over this side so I can be ready. Oh, never mind. Oh. I just thought the scariest thing ever if they did in a video game. What? I don't know how well that would work technologically, though. He got me, I'll admit it. But, this just randomly came to me. What if a game could record your audio, like your microphone feed, if it was available, and then distort it and play it in the distance? Can you imagine that for, like, you know, people like me who play video games online? That'd be terrifying. Just like out of nowhere, hearing a slightly echoey, distorted version of you talking. That'd be terrifying. Or if there was like some enemy that would echo you and it would like save. I guess there would be a lot of security concerns if a game like that existed. I mean, like, oh, this game is always listening. It's like, well, only when it's on. Oh, but it could data mine you for secrets. What if your parents were, like, saying credit card numbers in the background? So, yeah, I guess it would have to be, there'd be a lot of different things you'd have to do with it. And you probably have to get through, like, a lot of loopholes and people get really mad at you. But in just, like, terms of a horror game, that'd be cool. There was a game, I forget what it's called. But basically, it's, like, it's one of those, you know, you're playing God and you have to, like, make your people happy and everything. And like, oh, are they serving you? Are they not serving you? Stuff like that. I forget what it's called, but you also are in control of like this giant animal monster thing. And you can fight other giant animal monster things. I've never played it, but I heard good things about it. Oh, there you are. Knew you were there. But wait for it. Alright. I don't know if you have to wait that long, but it hasn't failed me yet. Except for stinking puppy. What was I saying? But apparently it was actually known for... Oh, get that. It was actually known that it would, like, literally... This is before all the regulations. It would literally data mine your computer. Crap. Alright, there he's going. But it would, like, data mine your computer and, like, find random names. And then an audio file every now and then when someone would die. It would, like, play it in the distance. So it would be like... Primed and ready for it, too. Come on! There we go. Go, 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 go. Alright, Mangle's there. Crap up, Balloon Boy. I don't got time for you. Freddy is staring me down. Okay. Alright, there. So I guess with Mangle, you only have to wait till the noise stops. Oh. I keep doing that. Keep sliding that a little bit. Ooh, oh, I'm dead. I died. Not even trying. Literally, I missed, so I'm just like, I'm dead. But yeah, I forget what the game's called, but I heard about it, and it was, like, really cool, like conceptualized. It was kind of a cool concept. But at the same time, did I use that word right? I may not have used that word right. But at the same time, it was like, dude, it's data mining your computer. Sure, it's not doing anything bad. It's only looking for names so that it can, you know, say them to creep you out. But at the same time, dude, it's data mining your computer. I am hearing things in the distance. It is Halloween after all. Dun, dun, dun. I might have to go through all the other Five Nights at Freddy's games. Just like, just go to the first level, nowhere else, and just see if there's a pumpkin or something. I think it's funny. It's just like, it's a nice little touch, you know? Happy Halloween. Bonnies are coming in on both sides! Ah, no. Bonnies are coming in on both sides. Ah, Chica. Chica. You are truly the bane of my existence in this game. I want you to know that, Chica. Oh, crap. I don't know if I was fast enough. Yeah, off camera, Chica killed me a few more times. Well, we're good. In all honesty, though, Chica, bane of my existence. In the first game, I had her down like, good. You know, I had her in the bag. It's easy. This game... They're just high. Okay. Oh. Now for the scariest thing in the game. That just terrifies me, and I wish more animatronics did that. Oh, crap. But being completely honest, that is scary. Something. Okay. Something for me. Oh, I don't know if I was fast enough. Something for me. Something that is true. I once upon a time made like 8 things to make a game scary. I don't know if I should reference that game. That episode is kind of rubbish. It took a lot of time though. It was kind of my first I don't know how to put it. It was my first kind of review-ish top 10-ish video. For what it's worth, ah, crap, now both chicas. For what it's worth, it was all right, but it was kind of rubbish in my opinion. I don't know. It's kind of one of those things like I can do better. I know I can do better. Oh crap. They're just switching out! Okay, it's gonna have to be quick. Alright, we're good. Alright, Mango might kill me. I didn't even register the whole... Okay, so... Classic's gone. Classic is gone. I didn't register the whole police thing, but, I was saying something. It was like, I was saying words earlier. Yeah, but I made that video forever ago, and it was kind of rubbish, in my opinion. It wasn't that good. Alright, we're good. But it was still fun to make, and it was still a learning experience, and that's what matters. I plan on making more of those kind of videos. But something I should have added. When you see something that you know can kill you, it is an extreme... Aw, man, I'm, like, out of flashlight. But, alright. Like, you know, it is on the forefront of your mind. This thing can and will kill me. Alright. Come on. I don't know if that's slowing it down or anything, but... Nope. If I'm dead, I'm not bothered because my flashlight was running out. But seeing something... Okay. Go. Seeing something that can kill you... But having some kind of safety. Alright, we're gonna flip. Like this, seeing them and watching them leave is terrifying. And I'll fully admit it. It's just scary. But, oh. but like watching him move is that much scarier. Yeah, I'm dead. I'm gonna keep fighting now. I might make it. Yeah, I might make it, might not. I don't know. I'll keep talking. But like watching Bonnie move around you is like, dude.
Hello.
Yo, like if you're trying to be scary. Alright. There we go. Crap, Freddy. Come on, 5 a.m. Give me a chance, buddy. Give me some love. Give me some love, please. Give me some love. It's gonna be close. Alright, go. It's like, if we make this, it's gonna be close. Praying for more juice. Oh, I was like, what's that noise? Oh yeah, mango. Yeah, that, wait, hang on, but mango was in there. Alright, we're good. Mango was in there. Oh, flashlight down. I repeat, flashlight down. Pray for all your worth. Oh. Chica's gonna kill me in, is it? Please, 6 a.m., come on. Come on. I hate you so much, Chica. So why don't you... I was there. But, to continue my thought, just to finish it off. It's like, for example, like, let's say you have, like, one-way glass or something. I don't know why, just ignore the scenario, you have one-way glass. And on the other side is some kind of monster. And you're holding your breath, you know, because you don't want them to hear you somehow. And you know he's looking for you. And you can see him and he can't see you. But you know the moment he notices you, he'll kill you. You know, like 90% of this game? 99% of this game? That is truly just terrifying. And I love it. Yeah, I'm not very much into horror games, I'm gonna be honest. I've only played a few. But that is something Five Nights at Freddy's tackles very well. Like, just because I don't play horror games often doesn't mean I can't, like, appreciate them, compliment them, and say, hey, what I like and what I don't like. But that is something, a feeling, Five Nights at Freddy's does very well. Just like, dude, they're there. They're right there. They're going to kill me. And I can't do anything about it. I'm powerless. Crap. I'm powerless, scared, and I don't know what to do. Oh, crap. I think that means more blood. Yep, there he is. Okay. Go. Alright. Yeah, so I can leave after the first one. Or at least it works with Balloon Boy. Yeah, I'll have to practice that somewhere else, too. But anyway, sorry. Back to work. Ah, crap. Cut that part out where I say, oh crap, by the way, because of the stupid Morton security. We really need to get that updated. But yeah, ignore that part. What the? That was weird. It was like a glitch. Where, okay, so... I died. Due to Chica, again. And it, like, forced my camera down, and the noise was playing, like, when the classics was killing me. Nothing's here, though. Now I want to, like, look around. Alright, even if I die and lose battery today. Okay, they're still there. Okay, hang on. I'm sorry, but that was weird. I don't know if that was a glitch or what. Alright, come on. And hey, maybe from searching around, I may lose all my stuff, but... Still. All my stuff, you know, the... Get the crap out, man. And other body. That was a bit delayed, but still. Feeling's still there. You jerk. Just want y'all to go away. Look, okay, see, look. Oh. I'm getting to think that Balloon Boy is like the herald. Well, okay, he is the herald of Foxy, but like even more so than just like, oh, by the way, if, you know, like if I'm gonna take away your flashlight. If you gotta take it away, at least put fresh batteries in. Sheesh. Be polite. It's like when you have to borrow, you know, a friend of yours' car. The polite thing to do is like, hey, come borrow your car. Sure. Bring it back. Okay. Bring it back with a full tank of gas. It's like, it's the polite thing to do. Too many noises, I wasn't sure. I heard like three at once, so that's why I was like, which one's the one saying I'm good? I'm like, oh. Yeah, you bring it back. Come on. It's what you do. Yeah, jerk. Yeah, jerk. Alright, Screech. Oh, crap. I'm yet to be. That may have been too little.
Hello.
Yeah. Sorry, I'll keep going. I just hate Chica now. Survived a Chica encounter. I'm just like... Hey, that's an achievement for me, surviving a Chica encounter. And once again, I've been using the flashlight too much. Something else a friend of mine mentioned to me, though, as long as I'm talking. Apparently, Chica. Screw you, Chica. But, apparently, there's supposed to be Golden Freddy in this game. And apparently, unlike, the other game, where I literally could never summon him, that irked me, I'm gonna be honest. That honestly irked me, that I couldn't summon him. I never encountered him. Ready. Wait. Alright, there you are.
Hi.
But, yeah. Apparently Golden Freddy's in this game, and he's actually like an animatronic that like attacks you regularly. Me being an idiot, of course I've never encountered him. Yep. And there's supposed to be two others that appear on like very, very, very rare occasions. Supposed to be like, script. Apparently, like a Phantom Freddy? A Phantom Bonnie? Nope. I don't know what they're about, but it's apparently like this darkness kind of thing. I don't know. It sounds really cool, but if I see it, I'll tell you. But considering I'm kind of, you know, I'm not freaking out and saying, activate maximum overdrive. Oh, it's a mangle. I'm like, alright. Two birds, one stone. Come on. Alright, there you go. But what was I saying? Did you see that? Chica's! The Chica's like, I got top, you got bottom. He's like, I'll get him from overhead, you just shirt out again. But yeah, apparently it's supposed to be like a Phantom Freddy and Bonnie. They're supposed to be like a Golden Freddy. Like a so-called Golden Freddy. I don't know. Hey, if I see him, I'll tell you guys and I'll try to figure out what to do. I imagine it's just going to be a quick flip on the mask, but I don't know. I got to fight the good fight here. Okay, so I was just about to wind it back up. Bonnie. There it goes. Never mind. I was like, so I'm sitting here going like, so I might die by the puppet. I shouldn't though. And then Bonnie. Whoa. Hey. Unscripted. Unscripted. I didn't expect that at all. S-A-B-E? I could... Is this the establishment? Safe? Is that supposed to be a human? I think I'm Freddy. Okay, here's the party room. Why is all this... I'm guessing that's blood. I'm just going like, alright, puppet. A giant? I'm in the present room? did I win? I'm just like, I tried to go to the present, but the present, I'm guessing, wasn't it. So I tried to go, and I was like, present, I can't tell if this is good enough. We'll try to go to the thing. Did I win? I don't know.
Come on, Chica, leave me alone. Okay, I'm good. Hopefully Fox doesn't kill me.
Hello. Alright, just that way Mangle hangs down. It's scary.
So I always start, see, since I haven't been killed by the puppet yet, whenever the little music box starts winding down, I always start talking. Just because I'm like, I want you guys to see it. Now, obviously, I don't have to be speaking for you guys to see something, but when I'm editing and not really paying attention and playing the Uncharted series, which I've been, which I've been doing recently, I will admit. Come on. Alright. We're good. You. Come on, come on, come on, come on. But when I'm not paying attention, it's just kind of like it clicks sooner for me, you know. Oh, never mind. I was expecting something. But you know, it's kind of like more of a signal. It's like, hey, stupid, look at me, look at me. Come on, pay attention more. Yeah. Nope. Just me. I'll keep trying though. 2-1. Come on, 2-1. Nailed that. My flashlight, though. Crap. Either Puppet's gonna kill me, or something's gonna kill me. No! What the fuck, man? I was like, I don't know what, but something is going to kill me now. I've been doing this for an hour. I want to be done.
No. Itch my nose. Come on.
Well, never mind.
I'm just sitting there saying, like, I'm getting sloppy. I know I'm getting sloppy.
I don't know. Like, other games, I could just... power record. This game, not so much. I don't know, like, at first you get, like, more on your A game, and then you just kind of, like... Yeah, I heard some reviewer once, they were reviewing the first Five Nights at Freddy's, and they were saying, like, they really enjoyed how someone, you know, pretty much only one person with an insanely small budget was able to make something that many horror games have, like, huge teams and huge budgets. How much if I just hold it? could do something to scare people. I mixed up my words. Someone with almost no budget and pretty much just one guy, could make something more scary than something that, like, a huge team of developers with a ton of money could do. And he really liked that. But what he didn't like was that he couldn't play it for more than a few tries because it agitated him so much. So he's like, I'm really impressed by the skill, but I can't. But the thing is, it's done so well that I can't play it for very long at a time. I thought that was funny. Oh no, I'll give it a few more tries. I might just have to call it a night. I'm gonna die. Oh, maybe not. Made that. It was like Chica, oh crap, and then Bonnie, oh crap. Now Freddy, ah crap. Foxy is still my favorite though. Out of, like, if I had to take a poll, who's my favorite? It's Foxy. Just, you know, he's like, everyone else is, you know, like, walking very calmly up to me. Foxy's like, screw it, catch him when he's not aware. Alright, I'm taking, Gotta keep going the distance. Sorry. Ew, my pumpkin's gone. So as you can see, I took a break. And someone, actually on the internet, I looked up strategies. They suggested an odd strategy. I'm gonna try it. It's interesting. Literally. Oh, there it is. You just wind it up until you hear a noise. Flash, flash, flash. That's it. Because nothing can go through the front hallway unless you hear a noise. And nothing can get through the ventilation. Unless you hear a noise. And then you just immediately flip on the max. That's the whole strat. It's kind of interesting. So I'm just like... with the mask. And like every time you look back, you immediately put on your mask. There's Mangle. Yeah, no one can kill you without you hearing it. So... so you heard that. See, he's coming through. But listen. There's the noise again. Flash, 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 flash. Okay. It's an interesting strategy, I'll give it that. I'm not putting much faith into it. This is literally just me experimenting. But why not? I'm not doing any better on my own, am I? Wait a second. Oh. I may be dead. I don't know. I might have died. It was like... okay, I don't know. I don't like that strategy very much. I guess the reason I don't like it... I'm sure it works. Like, I'll implement it into my strategy. Which is just literally, you know, hit the thing when you can. But, there's a lot of me not knowing. And I don't like that. I don't like not knowing what's there. That's just me personally. I like knowing. Now granted, this is not a game that lets you know very much. But still, I don't know. I'll keep trying though, I mean. I'm a little nervous as always, but I'll keep trying. I miss my pumpkin. It's like, I miss my pumpkin! My pumpkin was my friend! Click, click. Oh, someone's there. Click, 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 click. I still don't know how much is enough, which throws me off so much. Go, 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 go. Go, go, go. Alright, we're good. Sorry, it's like Freddy gets me. I'm like, alright, this isn't gonna be good. Ah, oh, man. Classics are just on me. I think they're actually referred to as withered. But I was like, look. Oh! Dang it, that was my bad. I'll admit that. Actually, wait, nah, that might not have been bad. Well, either way, it was my bad, obviously, but. Oh! Okay, here we go. Is it please be a different one? Oh, it's WASD. Take cake. Share? Why are none of them happy? I want them to be happy. I'm feeding you. Why is that purple guy? Did he just kill someone? That kid is crying and he turned. What's going? Wait, he's gray. Take cake to the children. I'm trying to. Wait! But I died by the purple guy. And now the purple guy. Well, yeah, the purple guy, Bonnie. So that was the puppet jump scare. So, I was trying to make the kids happy. They were getting unhappy, but that's fine. I was entertaining them. There was a kid outside. He got... the purple thing came in, and he did something. I don't know. But he changed... it's hard to tell the lines. but he changed color to gray and then blue came out, so I can only assume that's a skeleton and he was crying. So the purple guy killed him. And then all the kids were unhappy because probably they saw the body. And I'm sitting there like, da crap. I called. That was my bad. I'll admit it. That was my bad. But I'm going to get this. I'm going to get this. You trust me on this. I'm going to get this. Once I get my pumpkin back. I want my pumpkin. He'll ward away the bad people. Just trust me on this. He'll ward away the bad people.
Hi.
Go away, bad people! I know I said I would shut up, but I don't want to.
Fox is gonna kill me.
Ah, there we go.
I think I scared away like two or three different ones in that one day. That's why I was like, oh, crap. Puppet's gonna kill me. Puppet's gonna kill me. Puppet. Kill me. Screw you. Who's like me? Oh, awesome. I like how these are happy more often. I like that. Alright, so give H he I think I heard help them give life. Am I the puppet? What? So those are slumped. Well, okay, it's the same color as the child outside, so Golden Freddy? So at first I'm just like, then, wait, what? So, the puppet, so in that, let's see, in the first one, okay, ignore the first one, the second one, save them, or I don't know what it was called, the first one was save them, I think this one was help them, but in that one, I was helping the kids and there's a kid outside he probably wanted to be in too, but I don't know, maybe he couldn't afford it or his parents weren't with him or something, and he got killed, and the puppet killed me. Which leads me to suspect that he's the puppet. Well, I don't know, like, see, this one leads me to suspect that's like, these are the spirits of the dead children, and the puppet, who is at the prize counter, is like, hey, gift, take it. And it's like, oh, I'm still unhappy. Well, I'm in my animatronic, maybe they can be too. They shoved him in there. But, I don't know if that's just me kind of remembering a game theory video, or if that's like, that's what it seems like to me, just looking at it logically. It's like, well, I don't know if that one kid is the puppet. I can only guess that because the puppet was what killed me. But why did Golden Freddy kill me? Or maybe it's just because Golden Freddy killed me because insert Golden Freddy, I don't know. Because, we need an animatronic here, and we don't know which one is gonna be, so, how about this one? I don't know. I feel like I'm doing better. And I know I'm not. It's like, I think I'm doing good! Are you? No! I'm not! Alright. Also, I think I figured out Maximum Overdrive. See, in Five Nights at Freddy's 1, Maximum Overdrive was close the right door whenever you look up. In this game, Maximum Overdrive is put on the mask. It's like that. The whole having to wait like 5 or so seconds, however long it is, that irritates me so much. Get the crap out. Foxy, you're my favorite, but get the crap out. Nah, I didn't make it. I don't know why. The mouse went over, but it didn't register. Nope, kill me. I was like, literally just went flip. I'm like, wait, why didn't it go? Yeah. I was doing good. I was like in the zone too. Like, okay, quick playback right now to some of like the facial emotions I made. You can tell. I was into it. I was like, come on. Because it hurts me to go, eh, because I have dry lips. So it's like, eh, ow.
Need to fix that crap.
No. Come on. Chica might get me. Someone's going to get me. I'm just like, either Chica, Maggie, the Mangy, or the puppet. Someone's going to get me. I'm pretty getting consistent to 3 to 4 a.m. Remember before I was getting to 5 a.m. I was like, come on, 5! Yes! Ah. If I could just make like an uglier look on my face, I don't know. Scream. I still live like the moment I see Chica. Not Bonnie, Chica. I'm just like, screw you! Even though Bonnie, I think, has consistently killed me more often. I don't know. I think they're pretty even, actually. Yeah, this is their revenge. Because all last game, all FNAF 1, I was just like, no! No one, Chica and Bonnie are not gonna kill me! I will not give them the joy and the pleasure! This game, they're just like, nope, hey, we're getting the joy and the pleasure. They've almost always have killed me. Freddy's killed me a few times, the puppet has killed me none. Excuse me, Foxy and the Bloom Boy and their combined efforts, I think, have killed me twice, I want to say. But almost consistently, it has been some iteration of Bonnie and screw you, Chica. Distract Chica. I don't get why Chica rips off her face. That just doesn't compute. I mean, okay, so the reason they're killing me is because they think I'm an animatronic, and they're like, oh, you're not wearing a suit, you're breaking the rules, screw you, and they're forcing me into a suit, right? Well, one, why is it when they jump scare me they're so violent then? And two, if this is the case... We're good. Freddy! Crap. Come on, I got places to go. People to see! Alright. Oh. Okay. I think she got me. Well, I mean, why would you rip off her face if, like, they're like, oh, you're breaking the rules by not wearing a face? Strikes me what I should be able to do is very calmly walk. Oh crap. I'm dead. Something's gonna kill me. Where am I? Ah, come on. I'm dead. I died. Puppet. I'm ready for you, puppet. Oh! Mangle's gonna kill me, though. Or Foxy. Oh, there it goes. I was literally just about to flip. I had my finger on control. Actually, I had my finger on control like the whole time, but... Still. It's funny when I'm playing this game and I'm just like, something's gonna kill me. And there's like three threats are coming in at once. I'm just like, I don't know what it is, but what do you got me? Whoever you are, get in line. I'm gonna keep trying, though. Perseverance is key. And whining stupid music box. You know, like from now on, if I ever hear like the little children's xylophone little thing, I'm gonna freak out. It's not, well, like, yeah, is it gonna be because of this game? It's gonna be because of the last game. I'm gonna hear children's laughter. I'm gonna be going, Bloom Boy! Die, Balloon Boy! And they're gonna be looking at me like, what? Who are you talking to? I'm like, Balloon Boy! And then I'll get thrown in the mental asylum. That's just not good. Food there is terrible. Okay, someone's gonna kill me. It's either gonna be Mangle, Freddy, or Puppet. Like, someone's going to kill me. Bonnie, not now, Bonnie. Bonnie, leave. Bonnie, please. Bonnie, sweet, lovely Bonnie. Get that crap out. Now Foxy's gonna kill me. Oh, never mind. Foxy's not there. Thank you, God. Okay. I was like, get that crap out, everyone. Foxy, you're my favorite, but you know those friends that, like, you admit they're really good friends, but you can't hang out with them? Too long? That's Foxy. Love, man, but sometimes too much is too much. Alright. Alright, something's in the vents. Alright, it's Mangle. Alright, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. It always freaks you out when there's like overlapping thuds. So it's like, is that the thud of someone leaving? Is that the thud of someone going? Okay. That's the thud of someone coming. Come on. I don't know if it makes a difference if I move or not. I like to think it doesn't, but I also like to think it does. You feel like you shift it a little bit, they stay longer. That'd be funny. Ah. Okay, get rid of Mangle and Chica. Get rid of Mangle and Chica. Okay, okay. Wait, yeah? There we go. Crap. Doing good? Alright, doing good. I'm using my flashlight too much, though. Alright. Someone's gonna force it down. Someone's gonna force it down. Or not. Go, go. Alright. Still use my flashlight too much. Alright, Mangle's in the room. Mangle's in the room. Flash, flash. That's one leaving. That's the other leaving. I kind of like Mangle for that reason. Mangle's like the easy version, because Mangle you can hear. It doesn't matter, you can hear Mangle. And it's obvious when Mangle's in the room, because you hear that noise, which is kind of cool concept, really. Go, go, go. Ah. Come on, come on, come on. Good. I'm always afraid of okay, so I said earlier I figured out maximum overdrive. I think I already said that. Maximum overdrive is just simply when you immediately flip on the mask. Alright, something's gonna come for me. I don't know what, but something. Come on! Hey! Okay, go. Come on! Flip, flip! Alright, get rid of Manga, get rid of Bonnie. Please. Alright, silence. Crap. Okay, come on, come on. No! Near! 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 Come on! Screw it. Okay, is this Freddy? It's just the big titular character. Oh, yes, thank you, God! Yes! Like, he's just the big character, the main antagonist. Jeremy Fitzgerald, $100 and 5100s. 5100s, welcome to the family. Fazbear Entertainment. Yeah, welcome. No, phone guy said that the place is on lockdown. I'm getting that crap out. Screw you guys. We got... I think I earned the company Chidori yet again.
I got it! Yeah! Stroke, it's so beautiful, I'm a star.
Alright, so, what I've gleaned, I think that's the right word, from that strategy. Let's see, the strategy originally said this. Stay on the screen and just hold down the music button. And the moment you hear anything in the vents, and the moment you hear the little, you know, like, dun, 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 dun. Dun, dun. You know, like the thing where like they're coming. That's the moment when you need to like flip down. Look. All right, flash. All right, we're good. But something I'd like to add to that is one. I don't feel like that's entirely necessary. I mean, it works. The logic is sound. I just realized that my finger bends this way. I actually haven't noticed that for a while. It just like naturally bends. Probably because like being a gamer for so long, it just does that too. But no, hey. Say, you keep playing the sound. But I feel like you don't
have to do that, but it makes sense because it's like, alright, so you know the moment you see something, you're gonna be there for about 5 seconds or so, and that's about half of the music box. So it's actually longer than, you know, 2 halves, 10. It's actually longer than 10 seconds, as you saw when I was, like, really pushing it, where it was, like, red, red, red. I was like, please, please, please leave. Flip.
This is good.
This is good. I like this. But, yeah, that's what I kind of like about this game. I should stop comparing to the first game. But the first game was very final. It was always a thing of, like, you either get it now or you'll never get it. Ever. This game off-puts that a little bit by saying almost everyone is gonna give you some time. It may be a second, it may be a second and a half, or even just half a second, but you still have... I feel like you have more time with everyone. And then it's like, well, now that we're giving you... It was like yin and yang. Alright, so now that we're going to give you this new thing that, yeah, you get a little bit more time. There is... How many animatronics total? Let's see, we got the 4 new ones, the 4 classics, Puppet, Balloon Boy, so that's 10, Golden Freddy, and someone... Okay, so the little, like, barbed wire... Okay, I know it's not barbed wire, but, like, the little strings of stars that keep making me think they're barbed wire. Sometimes when I'm, like, flickering through rooms, like, I did this in the beginning, sometimes when I'm flickering through the rooms, I thought I saw, like, eyes. Like, I honest to goodness thought I saw eyeballs. I was just like, oh crap, what the? And then it was like, I flip back, light. Huh. It was like, huh. Hear the noise. Oh crap, back to work. That's something also. Sorry, let me just rant for a little bit. That's something also that I need to kind of, like, say I don't like as much. I don't like very much about Five Nights at Freddy's 2. So if you guys have watched me for a while, you know I value story. The only thing I value more than story is gameplay. The gameplay here is solid, but the story, I feel like as the nights go on, you know, the story thickens, but the gameplay almost gets in the way of it, because I'm so focused on not dying that it's kind of hard for me to, like, explore and say, whoa, what was that? I don't know. Now, granted, there's, like, no good way to implement that. There's pretty much no way for me to go, you know, for there to be a way where you can do that. There just isn't. Other than custom night, which is set everyone to zero. You know, check the lights just to see if Fox is there, just for fun, and then going and looking around like I did in the first game. There's no good way to do it, so I never want to give problems when I don't have a solution. Now, sometimes when I just say, like, the story sucks, it's hard for me to give a solution, but at the same time... So I just noticed that when Bonnie turns into classic Bonnie, flip back, that his eyes are white. Leave it on that screen so you guys see that. Yeah, I just noticed that. It's just like, well, see that? His eyes were white. But anyway, I'd have to say my biggest complaint about this so far. And I had that complaint in the first one too. That is like, as the story, you know, would think thickens, the more it thickens, the more it's like, well, you're too focused on not dying to appreciate the story. Does that make sense? I'm sorry, I keep looking down because my face cam's there. So I'm trying to, like, seeing how I look. I'm sorry. So that's why if you see me like this, that's why. You know, the camera's up here on my laptop. But, yeah, that's a complaint I have. I know I'm not done with the game yet, so I shouldn't be giving my, my thesis. But, I just felt like saying that, since I don't know if I'm going to be recording more today. I was kind of like, do I really want to do this? I think I will! So in the next episode, we will be tackling Sixth Night, which apparently, the last one was called Nightmare Mode by the fans. This one's called Golden Freddy Mode. So part of me is just like, oh, now Golden Freddy's here. So well then. So in the next episode, I'll be tackling that. Thanks for watching, I hope to see you then. watch it. It's 5 a.m. What in the world? I'm not even gonna see anything. Salutations.
Oops, I just stole that, didn't I?
Crap, I didn't want to, I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.